So in this trip to Africa, the purpose was to make a film of the Undersecretary of State for African Affairs, newly appointed with the JFK administration, which had just come in. The idea was to follow him around as he went from one country to another, learning directly just what's all about in each country. So we were to start out in Ethiopia, and I arrived a week or so early in Ethiopia. And somehow, I don't know how it was, I got an appointment to see the top guy there. And so I entered his office. On the floor was a rug with an enormous Star of David. And then as I passed this rug, I came to his desk, and there was this little guy sitting behind the desk with a military cap on and a chest covered with ribbons and medals and so forth. And we just stared at each other. This went on, I don't know, for at least 5 minutes. And I didn't feel uncomfortable, and I don't think he did, except there was a moment where I think he felt a little insecure. And that was it. And this was Haile Selassie, the Emperor, the Lion of Judah. And many years went by, and then a couple of years ago, I happened to run across a biography of the Emperor, Haile Selassie. Page 190, I believe, it spoke of the fact that the one thing that was forbidden in Ethiopia at that time was that any citizen cast his eye upon the emperor. And that explained suddenly why it was that he was so engaged and so fascinated with the opportunity to look somebody else in the eye. Because he could do that, because I was from another country. And then in those intervening years, my son, who's now 26, and who was at that time 6 years old, he came home one day with a pastel, a drawing. It suddenly I recognized, as abstract as the face was, it had a crown made of the Star of David, a man with a beard, little shoulders, indicating that he was kind of small, right, and vulnerable, and with a look in those eyes, which was exactly and only the precisely the look that Haile Selassie gave me. And there's no way that I can track it down except to think that somehow or other something genetic and unexplainable otherwise was taking place. And there have been connections like that with my son, especially when he was that young. At the same time, I remember when he was 6 or so, I remember going to Detroit and to do some commercial work. And my brother had to arrive several days later. When he arrived, he said that he had this extraordinary experience on the plane talking with a woman, a nun, who'd been a nun for 17 years and who had been working with people of the Holocaust and such, who where they were being held by Christians. And she gave my brother some literature, including a book. And my brother gave me the book, which I then read on the way back to New York. The book was by Elie Weisel, and it was called Night. I arrived home, opened the door, and sat down. My son, who had just made this sketch, handed it to me. I looked at it. It was a sketch that was drawn with a marker, And I said, how was it did you use a marker? And he said, oh, it was night. Well, the name of the book that Elie Weisel had written was Night, about the Holocaust, of course.